We're given the polynomial expression negative 7x squared minus 4y squared minus 8xy plus 7, and we're asked to evaluate the expression for x equals negative 10 and y equals negative 7. To do this, we'll perform substitution for x and y. We'll substitute negative 10 for x here and here, and we'll substitute negative 7 for y here and here. Once we perform this substitution, we evaluate the expression using the order of operations. To make sure we perform the substitution properly, when performing the substitution, we'll put the values in parentheses. So performing the substitution, we would have negative 7 times x squared would be the square of negative 10, minus 4 times y squared would be the square of negative 7, then we have minus 8 times x times y, which would be times negative 10 times negative 7, plus 7. Following the order of operations, there's nothing to simplify inside the parentheses, so the next step is to simplify the exponents. So we want to simplify the square of negative 10 and the square of negative 7. Well, the square of negative 10 means we have two factors of negative 10, and because negative 10 times negative 10 is equal to positive 100, we'd have negative 7 times 100 minus 4 times the square of negative 7 is equal to positive 49, and we still have minus 8 times negative 10 times negative 7 plus 7. Next, we multiply and divide from left to right. In our case, we multiply from left to right. So negative 7 times 100 equals negative 700, and we have minus 4 times 49, which equals 196, so we have minus 196, and then we have minus 8 times negative 10 equals negative 80, and negative 80 times negative 7 equals positive 560, so we have minus 560, and then plus 7. The last step is to add and subtract from left to right, but if it's helpful, we can write the subtraction as addition. Subtracting a positive is the same as adding a negative. So if it's helpful, we can rewrite this as negative 700 plus negative 196 plus negative 560 plus 7. This step is not necessary, but this expression is equivalent to this expression here. So now adding from left to right, we have negative 700 plus negative 196. When adding numbers with the same sign, we add their absolute values and keep the sign. So negative 700 plus negative 196 equals negative 896. We still have plus negative 560 plus 7. And then negative 896 plus negative 560 is equal to negative 1,456. And we still have plus 7. Again, to find this sum, because the two numbers have the same sign, we add their absolute values and keep the sign. And then finally, negative 1,456 plus 7 equals negative 1,449. Here we're adding numbers with different signs, so we take the absolute value of both numbers and subtract the smaller absolute value from the larger absolute value, and then use the sign of the number with the larger absolute value. The absolute value of negative 1,456 is 1,456. The absolute value of 7 is 7. So we take the larger value and subtract the smaller value, which gives us 1,449, but we know the sum must be negative because negative 1,456 had the larger absolute value, or because the negative 1,456 outweighs the positive 7. Before we go, let's check this on the graphing calculator by entering the expression in this form here. So we have negative 7 times the square of negative 10 minus 4 times the square of negative 7, minus 8 times negative 10 times negative 7, and then plus 7. Which does verify our work is correct. I hope you found this helpful.